So hey there guys, you're back with IDED of IDEDOnline, and today we're taking another look at a great Android game. Today's one is Pocket RPG. Yes, this is a unique dungeon crawling adventure from Cresent Moon Studios. Now they're quite famous for doing quite a lot of games when it comes to the Android tablet. They're quite impressive to say the least of them. So what we're going to do is, I've got a game as you can see on the resume, but I'm actually going to go New Quest. Now, in this game, you've got three different available classes to choose from. Now, these classes are the Dark Ranger, the Battle Mage, and the Blade Master. So, as you can see them here, this is our Dark Mage here, or Dark Ranger, our Battle Mage, I should assume, is this one here, and the Blade Master is the guy in the center. Now, each one of them has a different style of combat, so it's down to which one you'd prefer. Now, the game itself, as you'd imagine, is a dungeon crawling adventure. It's available from the Android App Store for about £1.25 in the Great British Pounds, that is, and it's most probably translates to about $1.80 in American. So if you can afford that, then this is one to get your hands on. It is a fun little dungeon crawler. Now, it is a slightly unusual one. So what we'll do is, I think for this one, I've already played as not the Battle Mage, but I've played as the Dark Ranger, which is basically a ranged combatant. So I'm going to try it with the Blade Master this time. So I start the adventure. Now, it does have an unusual feel to it, this game, because each time you start a level, you don't actually get to carry on with the equipment you had on the previous one. You start with brand new equipment each time, which to me kind of, I don't know, it put me off slightly, because I'm one of those people, I like to have my equipment, I always invest in getting decent equipment, but this one's more about leveling up your character than it is about gaining the equipment. So it's an unusual feel to it. But still, nonetheless, we'll play through some of it so you can get your own feel for it and see what you think about it. Now, over here is your control, so you can move around. Over here is your attacks, and you can obviously direction those, etc. From here, you have your inventory there, where you can select obviously different weapons to go in different slots, and your equipment appears up here. And if we go back by clicking the box at the top, you have here your menu. So what we'll do is we'll carry on through. Now, it's worth attacking stuff like hedges, as they may well have different bits and pieces in them. Alright, so apparently it's all gone, they ate it all. But yeah, so you're looking to collect money as you go as well. The money you actually keep, so there you go, there's some coinage there, so we'll keep that. But the coinage you keep between missions, you use that to level up your character. So, big important factor here, that you want to make sure you keep hold of as much money as you can do, because it's the one thing that you're going to take between each level. So don't get too attached if you find an amazing weapon, which is the only thing that I think kind of put me off. Speak to him. There we go. You're too late. Those wretched slimes have retreated into their lair already. Oh, well. Garand, oh no. Well, he doesn't retreat into his lair. Look at him. He's right there. And we'll cut these bad boys up. There we go. Oh no! Cube slimes. Which kind of makes me think that it's jelly. So we'll get in there. We'll attack these bad boys. And you can see your health bar is at one side. You've got a magic bar as well. I'll try not to die too quickly. This is the reason I took the ranged combatant last time. Is the, obviously, when you've got ranged combat, it means you're not going to take as much damage because you're not up close, but hopefully the Blade Master is a little bit more robust. So let's go talk to this guy. You're the only hero I've met that looks strong enough to defeat the boss, plus you're still alive. Well, that's a great vote of confidence there. Thanks, buddy. You look like you're due because, well, you're the only one still alive here and everyone else is dead, so you should take on the boss. No one's offering any help whatsoever, but then when? Why should they, I suppose? Alright, so let's keep moving. We'll keep going up. I would raid all the hedges, but I don't think it's going to be an interesting video if I sit here just raiding hedges. Alright, so the swamp catacombs. So, as we move ahead, there you go. So we can see here it took 2 minutes to do that bit. No hero deaths. We collected 24 gold. We had 20 out of 20 monster kills. We looted 18 out of 32 items, and we found no secrets because there were none to be found. All right, and so there we go. We move ahead. Now that guy looks a bit more aggressive, to say the least of him, but we'll see. He may appear in the next level. Hopefully not, though. He looks a bit more challenging. Now, the issue I found with the range was he doesn't have as much HP. So that's the reason I didn't go for him to... Well, I did quite a lot, I have to admit. I completed quite a large section of it with that character. Mainly because, obviously, well, range is a good thing, but you have to keep running away. That's basically it. And I am a master of running away in games. I've learned that avoiding damage is pretty much the best way to go about it. Take that, you little monster. Alright, there we go. Is this... No, not a secret. Well, it was worth checking, wasn't it? It could have been. Cut down all these lamps, collect all of the coinage, get ourselves some money so we can do some levelling up afterwards. Yes, they were too much for us, but not too much for me. It's because you suck and I'm the hero here. Alright, so, cut up some barrels. Looks like enemies can be hiding in them. Open the chest. Ooh. A mediocre axe, eh? Alright, so let's go to our inventory. Let's have a look. So, mediocre axe of chipping. Worth 512, price is 128, physical damage 7, and attack speed minus 5%, but critical plus 5%. So, does physical 4, physical 4. So this one's better. So what we'll do is we'll change it with our main hand weapon there. And it is reflected on our character, as you can see. So it is quite nice in that sense. You're not just like left with the basic character looking the same all the way through the game. Each time you get a weapon, it does change your appearance, which is quite cool. Alright. Beware these waters, dreadful monsters lurk just beneath them. Okay, so we'll keep that in mind. Oh my goodness. And that's why you want to be a ranged character. Look at that damage. Oh my goodness. Alright, let's run through this because I don't really fancy getting my ass handed to me by a load of swamp tentacles. It doesn't look like we're doing much damage against them. Oh my goodness, and my health is so low. No. Explosive barrel. Keep away. We need some health. Where can I get some health around here? Give me health. Ugh! Tentacle, and a slime, die slimy thing, or maggot or whatever it was. Come on, someone give me some health. Ah, there we go, there's a little bit of health there, so that's not a bad thing. Let's get that. A couple of barrels. One coin, oh, two coins there. Let's keep moving. The monster's hiding, Make sure you have an exit strategy. Well, thanks for that, buddy. I'll make sure I learn to run away. Alright, there we go. Let's go, go, go. Keep aiming for victory. Oh, those are some big-ass slimes. And that's the only problem with, like, I suppose, having this close-range character. We're going to take so much damage because we've constantly got to be up close and personal with every enemy we fight. And he is not the most accurate of characters, I have to admit. There we go, we leveled up twice there in that little bit. There's obviously plenty of monsters there. There we go, open that chest as well. And grab up all this stuff and just destroy the place. Has everyone ever noticed that? In every game that you play as an adventurer of some sort, you're literally going to be ransacking everyone's houses, destroying everything you come across. I think that was the main thing with Zelda when I first played it. You're going to people's houses, breaking their pots, slicing up their garden for a few rupees, and no one's got any complaints about this. Everyone's perfectly happy for you to destroy their house, raid all of their stuff, and just take it. You're like the worst thief in the world. And you do it right in front of them as well, which is the thing. I suppose it would be a bit like a bit bad if you ended up with a situation where you do this and then they basically have a go at you and then come after you, because then you'd basically be the enemy of every townsfolk in every village you ever visit. But there we go. Alright, so let's carry on here. Speak to me. The shopkeeper is about your only friend in these dangerous places. He goes wherever the loot is, and monsters love loot. So wake him up. Come on, shopkeep, what have you got? So he's got some blades by the looks of it. So sharp sword of severing, worth 99, ooh, blimey, almost a grand, so we can't afford that. Shiny ring of might. So this is the problem with these sort of shops, is you look at it and you think, well, should I bother buying anything? Because if you buy anything from the shopkeeper, you're literally just losing it at the end of each level, and you want to keep your money. But I do think that you, when you get to the end of each level, it actually values up the gear you've got and sells it, so you do get something for it. So we've got a ring of impact, which is stun. We've got criticals, deadlier criticals, broken sword of strength. So what we'll do is we'll get rid of these. common sword of poking. Critical 5%, physical 7. So what we'll do is we're going to swap over that one. We'll get rid of that as well. And we've got these two here. I think for now, shopkeep, we're going to leave it as is. You can keep your loot and we'll just use what we've got. That's an exploding barrel, so we won't hit that one. And take some of that slime, yes. Fear the power of my swords. Brah. Yes, little spinny attack if you hold down the attack. Boom, look at that. Take out all of the slimes. Brah. Break the jar too. There we go. Now, you are looking for secrets in these places as well, because sometimes walls can be broken. Ooh, exploding barrel. Keep away from that. So if you find a broken wall you can break down, then obviously you're going to get extra stuff from it, which is always beneficial. And it looks like we've found ourselves a boss. Squelch, squelch. Blurgle, squelch. Blurgle, eh? Yes, level up gives us our health back. We want to take out these, yes, there we go. Stop them spawning more of these slimes. Because the less slimes we have to fight, the better. Yes, exploding barrel took out the thing. Ooh, so there are traps there. 2x damage bonus. Oh, got caught in that one. I was hoping to get away before I took the damage. Little health potion there. Oh, no. Oh, dear. Alright then. So, keep on moving through. Victory shall be ours, because we are victorious knight. Oh, there's a tentacle coming up, so let's get away from there. We don't want to get attacked by the tentacle if we can avoid it. Go through. Yeah, there we go. Just want to walk straight past those, because I don't think we can defeat them. Alright, fair enough. So, some doors travel between areas. Some avoid special bonuses. Tombs of the Fallen King, eh? Wasn't much of a king if he's fallen. Alrighty then. Let's go. Okay, so this moves us through to the next area. And there you go. So it took us 6 minutes to do that one. We got 398 gold. Our monster kills got 92 out of 99. So maybe we could have killed the tentacles. Liverpool's 71 out of 77, so that's not too bad. And we've got some, obviously, achievements there. So we can advance again, and we'll keep going until we get to at least the point where we can actually upgrade our hero in some way, because I'd like to demonstrate that as well within the video so you can see what it's like to be able to actually upgrade your hero in some way, shape or form. So what we'll do is we'll grab some more coinage. We want to get as much coinage as possible so we can get loads of decent little elements for our hero to make him nice and powerful. Come on, destroy the, I don't know what that is. The slime spawner, we're going to call it. There we go. Off with his head. And these cracks in the wall. Ooh, I didn't realise that was a trap there. Didn't really notice it. That was my own fault. I should have been paying way more attention there. Get all of that. Yes, level up again. Boom. I believe leveling up just increases our damage slightly, so we get a better baseline damage, more health, which can never be a bad thing. Where are these slimes all coming from? Is there like a spawner down here, I'm assuming? Let's go have a quick look. Yes, there is, that's why. Oh my goodness, and look at this amount of large slimes in here. We need to do something about this quickly, otherwise we're going to die in this room. Yes, there we go. Take that maggot and that tables. Alright, so we clicked some more stuff. We've got loads of these guys incoming. Oh, blimey. Where are you coming from? Go away. Leave me alone. There we go. Collect up some more loot. You die. Spawn smaller slimes from every big slime you kill. It's like an endless supply of slimes. Let's get rid of this spawner as well. Yes, another level up as we kill some more. Get rid of the maggots as well. running around to smash the pile of skulls in the corner. Didn't really give us much, but still. Every little helps. There we go. Keep it moving. What's this guy got to say for himself? Alright, he won't talk to me because there's monsters nearby. There we go. There, your whole village. Your whole village can do anything about these slimes. And that guy looks way more armoured than me as well. Look at him. Look at him in his full suit of armour and all the rest of it, yet can do anything about the slimes. And yet I'm expected to be victorious. Right, well, there's a door there. Looks like there's those traps in the pit. Now, with the traps, you can actually lure the enemies onto them. They will take damage from the traps, which is quite cool. So you can use them to your advantage as well. You also want to watch out for areas where you go into it and you get locked in there. Beware of the ogre. Looks like we're going to have to face a bigger enemy, so that enemy from the loading screen will be in it. Ooh. Oh my goodness, where are these big slimes coming from? Oh, die! Die, slimies! You all look like cubes of jelly. Raspberry jelly at that. Or maybe strawberry. Strawberry jelly. Anyway, nonetheless. Keep going, keep slashing, just tapping away like a madman. So you're going to get achy fingers from this game. That's one thing I can guarantee for you. Plenty of money though from these guys. Where are these slimes keeping all this money? And why do they have money? Everybody wants to speak to you. Alright, before we go through all of that stuff, let's go down here and see what that door was about. Because apparently we didn't go through it and I have a feeling that's obviously the way we need to go. So can we... Alright, so that door doesn't go anywhere. We can't go anywhere with it. So that was a wasted walk. Let's go back up. Triggering all the traps along the way. I would speak to you guys, but you look boring. And here is the boss. The ogre himself. The mighty baddie. So let's see how much of a challenge this guy really is. He could be quite menacing. And he appears that he is. Get a little spin attack in there. So can we... Yes, we can. We can lure him to attack. And then dodge, which is good. Ooh, it looks like those things at the side are actually quite venomous. Ooh, nope, gonna die. Ow. There we go. Ah, slime's jumping out the water. He's actually, ooh, he's quite a good boss, I have to admit. He's doing a lot of damage. Ah, but if we can lure him into those traps. Ooh. Level up, that's what we needed, get some more health back. Keep bringing it on. Yes, and he's down. Victory is ours. Alright, let's keep moving. Is this the end of the level? Doesn't look like it. Oh no, it is. There is the exit. And we're through. Victory. Can't be complained at that. Wasn't too bad. Now, as you can see, it's quite a fun little adventure game. There's obviously quite a lot to it. As I say, each time you start with new weaponry and stuff like that. I believe these sections here where you're advancing between them, you keep the weapons that you had, so that's not too bad. But obviously, each time you get to the end of a section, which I believe this is it, you'll then lose it. So you can see there, it refunds us the money for all of the stuff that we got, and you also get all your achievement money, etc. And so there's our grand total. So we'll click the arrow, we'll move ahead, and let's have a quick look at the next section. So we can click down here, and as you can see, here are your skills. You can basically pay your stars that you've earned during the mission to get these. So we've got Ground Sand, Power Strike, Whirlwind, etc. You can click on them to learn more information about them down here. And obviously go through to here, you can see that there are like techniques basically, or weapons that you can train in. So obviously by training in it, it gives you additional like if you've got that type of weapon, you're going to do more damage with it, and it will basically give you extra bonuses. So that's what you're looking at with this game. It's not about the actual item you have yourself, it's all about the bonuses you can add to having that type of weapon or having that type of attack available to you. So that's something to bear in mind when you're looking at getting this sort of game, if you're happy to keep on like basically just upgrading your character and replacing your weaponry. It is a lot of fun. I say it's not expensive, it's not a massively priced game. The graphics are quite nice and it is quite addictive and easy to play. As you can even tell by the length of this video, it's been 20 or so minutes over what, just a couple of short levels, and this game goes on for a long time. You saw the map, it was huge. So nonetheless, I hope you've enjoyed this Tablet Gaming Tuesday. Hopefully there'll be plenty more to come, and obviously we'll do a new game next week, so make sure to stay tuned and check it out. So till then, this is IDED signing off, and I'll catch you soon.